Now let us discuss about the third point and very very important point that every Angular developer must understand. How Angular service works when we inject it in component level, module level and app level. First let us see the component level. We created user service and injected in app component, which means we just injected in app component level. So since we injected in app component level, the same instance of the user service will be shared to the app component and its child components. In other words, when we injected a service in component level, then the same instance of the service will be shared to the component and its child components. So to prove that, let me demonstrate a count example. So I am in user service. So I am going to create a variable called count. Type number with value 0. So I am going to write a 3 methods, increment, and where we are going to increment the count by 1, and same way just have minus minus and another one get count, and where we written the count value. And now let's go to the app component.ts. And here the app component is the parent component and user component is the child components. Remember, we injected the user service in the app component. And here let us define the variable called count. In app component, I am going to create the 3 methods to call the increment, decrement and get count. So increment, and here we make call to the increment method of user service. So this dot user service dot increment, and same way let's write another 2 methods. And here once we get the count, we need to assign that one to the count variable, right? So just mention this dot count equal to this dot user service dot count, and we need to call this whenever we increment or decrement the value. So we need to use this dot get count. Now let us add 2 buttons, increment and decrement, in app.html and make a call to the increment and decrement methods of app component. To save the time, I am going to pause it. Now we can see that we have the 2 buttons called increment and decrement in app component, and we are calling the increment and decrement methods of app component when you click these buttons. And also we are showing the count value here. Just click on the increment button. Now you can see that value of the count value incremented by 1. Keep clicking, you can see the value is incremented by 1 each time. And if you click on the decrement, it is getting decremented by 1 each time. I am going to have the same logic in the user component.ts also. Just take this and go to the user component.html. Add this same logic here. And here instead of the app, just mention user component. Just save it. Now you can see that from user component. And let's add this increment and decrement methods also. Go to the app component.ts and just copy this. So here we are getting error because we didn't define the user service yet. So first import that user service, import slash user service, take the user service, and in the constructor just create the alias for that private user service and make user service and make this camel case, save it. And now we have the user service and we have the markup. What we are missing is count variable. So take this count variable and define it here, count. Now we are not missing anything. So we are having the increment, decrement and get count function also. So now just click on the increment button of app component. You can see the value is getting incremented by 1 each time. Now the value is 7. In the user component, let's click the increment button and see what will be the value of the count. So basically you expect the value should be 1. Because the initial value of the count is 0 now. You can see that value is 0 here. Just click on the increment. There you go. Now you can see the value 8. And just click on again 15. And just click on the decrement button of app component and see the value of the count. You can see the value 14. Why this is happening? Because here the app component and user component both are sharing the same instance of the service class. That's the reason you can see the value of the count is not reset when we call from the user component. If you just decrement now 9 and just if go and increment you can get the value 10. So whenever you don't inject the service inside the child component, the child component will share the same instance so that parent component shares, in this case app component. So but what will happen if I inject the user service in the providers array of the user component? Comma, enter, providers, and inside providers just define the user service. Now click on the increment button of app component. You can see the value is 4 now because I clicked it 4 times. So now just click on the increment. So as per the last scenario, the value should be 5. So now just click on the increment. There you go. Now you can see that value is 1. Keep clicking on it. So you can see the value 16 now. And when you go and click on the decrement or increment, let's say click on the decrement, now you can see the value is 3 instead of 15, right? Because in this case we just injected the user service in the providers of user component 2. So that's the reason now the app component and user component both shares the independent instance of the user service. Now let us understand how Angular Dependency Injection Framework instantiated the user service class in both scenarios. So in the first scenario, the Angular Dependency Injection Framework looked for the local injector in user component, but it didn't find. So it went one step up and it found the injector inside the app component. So whenever it found the injector in the app component, then automatically it will instantiate the service class. So that's the reason the app component and its child component, user component, shared the same instance of the service class. But in case of second scenario, the Angular Dependency Framework found the local injector in the user component. So it instantiated the service class for the user component. So that's the reason the app component and user component both shares the independent instances of the service class. So now let us understand how it works in case of the module levels. So currently we have the app module here. So what I'm going to do, new module called users module. So for users we don't have module. So in the users folder, just create a new file called users.module.ts. So module is nothing but an entity where you can group the similar components, directives, services, etc. So now let us create the module. So for that, let's first import the module now. So import ng module, and it is available from the angular/core. And same way, import another module called common module, which is predefined module of Angular. And then we are going to use the @ ng module decorator. Ng module, and it have some metadata. And before that, let us export default class users module, save it, and here now just use the imports, and in the imports we are going to import the common module. We discuss more on modules in other session. In this session, let us focus on services. So just use common module, and another one is declarations. And the declarations, we are going to mention our user component. So let us import our user component. Import user component. So just take this one and mention here. So I'm going to import this user module in the app module. So just go to the in the app module.ts, if you observe in the declarations we mentioned the user component. Now we don't need to mention the user component, just remove that. And from here also you can just remove it, we don't use it, that one. And instead of that, let us import the users module now. Module from users/module, take this users module. And so after the browser animation module, just import the users module. In user component module, we need to export the user component. So go to the user component module, and in the user component module, the way we have the imports, just add the export, and the exports array, we need to mention the users component. So now we can see that user component displayed here. So now let us see how to inject the service in the user module. So go to the user component .ts, and here instead of providing the service here, just remove it, and just take this and go to user modular TS, and here just import it, and here you can have the providers array in the module level, and take the user service and use it here. Just click on the increment, still you can see it is working. So this is how you can inject the service in the module level. So you can have the user service here. So when you inject the service in the module level, all the components of this module will share the same instance. Since we are using this user module in the app module, even if you remove this user service from the providers of the array from the app component and save it, and if you click on the increment, you can see that both are sharing the same instance. Now let us see the third approach, that is using the service at the app level. If you would like to have a single instance of your service globally, then you can inject it in app module. The way you injected in users module using the providers array, the same way you can define it in the app module. So just remove from the users module and maybe cut it here too, and go to the app module TS, and now you can see that you see the blank page because you got some error. Press the F12 and you can see the error here. So you can see the error called no provider for users service, right? So you can see that error from the app component TS. In the app.component, you can see that there is no provider. So now let's go to the app.module.ts. In the app.module.ts, let us import the user service first. Now take this user service and define that one inside the providers array of the app module. And now you can see that error disappears, and you can click on the increment and decrement, and even in the user component also it works as it is. Now we have the single instance all over the application.